Welcome back. There's growing anger tonight at visitors behaving badly in Bali, and this time it's not directed at us. In particular, locals are reportedly fed up with Russians and Ukrainians fleeing the war. There's so much backlash, Bali's governor has requested the Indonesian Foreign Ministry tighten visa requirements for arrivals from those two countries. Joining me now is an expert of modern Indonesia, Professor Greg Barton from Deakin University. Thank you for joining us, Greg. What are the driving factors in this anger?
Look, it's a bit of a perfect storm. There's been mounting anger over the last couple of decades with, you know, frankly, bogan behaviour. Foreigners, sometimes Australians, sometimes others, behaving badly. Bali was hard hit during the COVID lockdowns. It's now bounced back in terms of numbers of arrivals. But that's also saw some people staying through the COVID pandemic, boasting about the cheap lifestyle they were enjoying, working remotely, but not having the appropriate visas. And then a flood of particularly Russians coming in recent months. And that's on the background of a long history of Russian crime at some of the nightclubs and some of the drug trade. So it's the exception rather than the norm. You know, mostly things in Bali are going well, most people are well behaved, but the exception sure stands out.
We've also seen other potential crackdowns on foreign tourists in Bali, including a likely scooter ban. Why do you think we're seeing this shift in attitude? It does seem like the locals are saying enough is enough.
Yeah, look, Indonesia is a democracy. Australians often forget that. It struggles like all democracies, but it has rule of law. It's trying to do the right thing. There's often a contempt from Australians and others saying, oh, there's no rule of law. They don't have any proper rules. Well, it's the foreigners who are flouting the rules, who don't have the appropriate licenses to ride a motorbike, don't wear helmets often, certainly often are not properly clothed. Now, once again, it's exceptions, but those exceptions stand out. And so Indonesia is just doing the same reasonable thing. It's the same thing that we'd expect Australian authorities to be doing.
So tourism is the biggest industry for Bali, and obviously they were hit very hard, as you said, through the COVID pandemic. Is there a risk for the community, though, now in clamping down on foreigners and making all these rules for tourists?
I don't think so. I think these are reasonable rules. Most tourists recognise that. Most people who go regularly recognise that and want to see things work. I think most people are embarrassed by bad behaviour and, you know, whether it's our own Australians or others, and would rather the authorities come down hard on that, because that would be better for everyone. And Indonesia would like to lift its game with tourism. I mean, the tourism minister, Sandiaga Uno, has said he'd like to see more eco-tourism and more sort of high-end tourism. That's fair enough. That's the way that markets need to develop, including the Indonesian tourist market.
Do you think it's a bit harsh, though, on Ukrainians trying to flee a war zone to make it harder for them to be able to get into the country?
Look, I think we need to understand we don't know yet whether this is mostly Russians with some Ukrainians or what the proportion is. The Ukrainian consulate is saying most of the Ukrainians coming are women who are fleeing conflict and adjoining family reunions. I would have thought the Ukrainian community is pretty small. They say that they are and they're well behaved. Of course, most people wouldn't tell the difference between Ukrainians and Russians. The languages are related and sound similar. A lot of Ukrainians may even be speaking Russian. So I think there's probably a lot of confusion when they say Ukrainians and Russians. Maybe they're trying to be even-handed, as Indonesia was with the G20 in Bali back in November. But I would think it's mostly Russians that's the problem.
Okay, well, thanks so much, Professor Greg Barton.
Great to join you. Thanks very much.